What's going on, everybody? This is the third tutorial for Linguist series, and in this tutorial we are going to take it one step further. We are going to change our headnote, update our headnote, but not deleting the original headnote. We'll create a new headnote and point it to the original headnote. What I mean by that is, for example, I said insert 7 to a headnote, and our updated linked list will be like this. 7 will be in the front, and 1 will 7 will point to 1, blah blah blah, until the end of our linked list. There is two ways to solve this. In I'll show you the basic way and the more professional way, or whatever you prefer. Since you know we are going to update our headnote now, this function will need to return something because we are making changes in our linked list now. So it will go like this. Our function will return the parameter of linked list node pointer. And let's call this function change head. And after this, it will have two parameters, linked list node pointer, first the head parameter and integer data parameter. Let's start by creating our linked list first. Linked list node first. Linked list node pointer, let's say this, call this new head equals new linked list node of data. So after that, what we've talked about is that this new head, the new created node, will need to point to our head node, old head node. So let's create it now. Our new heads next will be our head node. And after this, we need to return something, because if you don't return something, these changes won't be in your global scope. And you can just return new head here, because since new head is our new head node. And after this, let's try it. Don't forget, since we are returning something from a function, we need to attach it to a variable, assign it to a variable. So our new head variable will be equals to change head and head as well as 7. After this, let's print our linked list and try this. As you can see, 7 is now at the front successfully. So let's talk about the other way. If you remember simple pointers in C++, for example, if you need to swap two variables and you want to do it in a function, you can't return two variables from a function. Therefore, you send pointers, the memory addresses of them, and swap in the function, and it will change all globally. So since our linked list node is just created in heap memory with pointer, we need to give pointer's memory address. Therefore, we need to use a double pointer here. Don't make it complicated. Just know that we need to give the memory address of a pointer. Therefore, we will use double pointers, okay? So since we are not returning something, I can write this function as a void function, change head, linked list node pointer as our parameter now, head node, and integer data. Let's first create our new node again. Nev node equals nev linked list node of integer data. Our new head will point to head. But if you write this, this will be wrong since it's a double pointer. You need to surround this with star guys. Sorry, reference. That's it. So let's continue. This will be new node guys. My bad. And this will be star. After this, we need to update our head node first. Since our head node is the previous one, it will go like this. We need to dereference our head node first. And after the dereference, we can just say that our new node is equal to our head node. Let's try this too. After this head, let's add 8 to the front too. So it will go like this, 8, 7, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I'm calling the change head function. Recall that we use the double pointer here. Therefore, you need to give the reference of it. So I gave it the reference address of our head node and the new node as 8. After this, let's print our linked list and give the head node to it. As you can see, we've attached 8 successfully. I prefer to use double pointers in linked lists because therefore I don't need to return anything and the function is much more better looking, I think. And this is the way you use pointers. This is the power of pointers. So see you guys in the next video. Take care.